Well, it's tough for some of the people who live here to believe as well, Aaron. But officials say it was that sparkler, along with a combination of some bone-dry debris that was under the porch and a propane tank that fueled the fire that destroyed this 7-unit apartment building.
This home video shows what those who lived in the apartment building at 158 School Street in Laconia managed to escape. Jeff Nixon was sleeping at 11:45 last night when the fire broke out.
I awoke to the sound, actually. It sounded like rushing water, crackling. And then I saw an unnatural light coming from the window. You could actually start to feel the heat already.
His neighbor says he was awoken too, but not by the sounds of the fire.
It was a terrifying scream of this dad looking for his son. So I looked out the window and I saw the flames and I saw the smoke.
Ferullo says he got his own son up.
By the time we got our shoes on and our clothes on and out the front door, which was maybe 90 seconds, the whole side of the house had gone up.
The fire chief says all 15 tenants in the building made it out safely, but the chief says one tenant tried to get back in the burning building.
He actually attempted to climb up a fire department ladder to get into the building in the height of the fire. He was quickly removed and arrested, and another tenant was, I believe, detained a little later on just for uncooperative behavior.
Authorities say someone playing with a sparkler ignited some debris under the porch, which started the fire. Ferullo says that fits with what a woman was saying.
She was running up the street, crying, holding her head, shaking her head. She kept saying over and over again, I can't believe a sparkler did this. I can't believe a sparkler did this.
Now for Jeff Nixon and others, it's a time to salvage what he can. But even as he dealt with the aftermath, Nixon was giving thanks that no one was hurt.
You've heard it before, and it's a true fact. Stuff is stuff.
Nixon says fortunately his parents have a place for him to stay. As for the other tenants, we're told that they're being assisted by the Red Cross. Reporting live in Laconia, Ray Brewer, WMUR News 9.